here I am having three numbers, 5, 10 and 15. Now we are going to find out the HCF and LCM of the three numbers. So first, what is the first step? Find the prime factorization of all the three numbers. So prime factorization of 5. What is the prime factorization of 5? It is what? 5 only. 5 is the prime factorization of 5. Because it is not further done, 1 into 5. So 1 is not a prime number, so we are not going to write that 1 over there. Now next is prime factorization of 10. So 10, what will you do? Start with the least prime number 2. It is divisible. 2 5s are 10. Further are we going? No. So the prime factorization will be 2 into 5. Next is prime factorization of 15. What is the prime factorization for 15? Start with the least prime number 2. But is 15 divisible by 2? No, because the last digit is 5. So it is not divisible. So go for the next prime number, which is next prime number 3. Is 15 divisible by 3? What will you do? Add the digits. 5 plus 1, 6. Yes, 6 is divisible by 3. So 15 will also be divisible by 3. So divide 15 with 3. What do you get? 5. Further, are we going? No, because 5 is a prime number. So this will be 3 into 5. Now HCF, how to find? HCF will be what? Common factor you are going to take. Which among this is common? Here you are getting 2, but in these two cases 2 is not there. Here you are having 3, but in these two cases you don't have a 3. But which number is coming common for all? Yes, this 5 is common for all. Any other factor is there which is common? No. There is no other factor which is common. If there had been any other, what you will do? You will take that also and then multiply. All these common factors you will take and multiply. Since here the common factor is only one number, what is that 5? HCF will be 5. This is the common that you are going to take, this common one. That is the HCF. Now LCM. LCM, how you are going to do? You will be taking all the prime factors in their maximum numbers. So which are the factors here? 2 is there, 3 is there, 5 is also there. Factors for all, there it is not common. All the factors. For the prime factorization of any given numbers, what are the factors there? You are going to take all the factors and multiply plus the condition in their maximum number. So you will have to multiply 2, 3 and 5. Now let us see these factors in how many numbers they occur. 5 is occurring here only one time, here also one time, here also one time only. So maximum number of occurring of 5 is only 1. So you take that 5 into. Next you are having a 2 over here. So 2 is occurring only here, that 2 only once. So you will take, that is the maximum number of times that 2 is occurring. So you take that 2 into. Next you go for next factor. What is the next factor? 3. 3 is occurring only in this prime factorization, there also only one time. So maximum time number of times is only once. So you take that 1, 3. Find the product. 5 into 2, 10. 10 into 3, 30. So 30 is the LCM of 5, 10 and 15, and 5 is the HCF. So hope you have understood that. Now we'll be learning one more method for finding the LCM. This is the quite common method by which we are finding LCM. If the number is more, the given number of numbers is more. If you are having 3, 4 or 5 numbers together given, and if you are asked to find the LCM, I think this method will be easier. That is division method. So here we are going to find the LCM by the division method. That is yet another one way of finding the LCM. So here you are given three numbers, 35, 45 and 60. So if you go for other method also, you can use and then find. But we are going to learn this new method, that is division method. How to find the LCM using the division method. Now what you do here is, you are going to divide all the three numbers or four numbers or five numbers, how many ever numbers are given, with the same number. See, it is not that you divide 35 with 5, 45 with 9 and 60 with 6. No. All the three numbers are taken together and we are going to do the division. So we will be doing like this. 35, 45 and 60 we are going to write like this. Now one more condition we are going to apply here. I told you, you will be dividing with the same number. Now sometimes it may so happen that only two of the numbers may be divisible, or only three of numbers may be divisible. Fourth number may not be divisible by the number what we are thinking. So it is enough that minimum two numbers are divisible by the same number what we are going to take. So when the numbers are given, you will be seeing among this, at least if two of these numbers are divisible by the same number, then you can go with the division. If all the three are divisible, well and good, no problem. So sometimes you may get a case where only two of them will be divisible. So in such cases, don't worry, the condition what we are having is minimum two of them should be divisible with the number what you are choosing. So here 35, 45 and 60. So all the three will be divisible by which number? Just see this and tell all the three will be divisible by which number. Look at the units place digit. 5, 5, 0. So all the three will be divisible by 5. So you are going to do the division of all these three numbers with 5 at the same time. So you will be writing this 5 over here and you are going to divide. So 5 in 35 how many times? 5 sevens are 35, comma. Again 5 in 45. 5 in 45 how many times? 5 nines are 45. And 5 in 60. It is divisible, we know. Now how to find that? Take one digit, that is 6. 5 in 6, how many times? 5 ones are 5. Mental calculation. 5 ones are 5. Here it is 6. So a balance of 1. That 1, next digit is 0. Bring that 0 also down. So that will be 1 and 0 forming a 10. Now you have to divide this 10 with 5. So 10 with 5 when you divide, what do you get? 12. That is, 10 when you divide with 5, you will get 2. That is 5 into 2 is 10. So 12, 5s are 60. That is how you are doing the mental calculation. Now, next, again you are going to divide. Here also, you are going to apply the same formula. That is, at least 2 of them should be divisible by the same number. Now here it is 7, 9 and 12. Are all the 3 divisible by the same number? No. Why? Because 7 is a prime number. It's a prime number. The other two are composite numbers. So 7 will be having only two factors, 1 and 7. And 9 is not divisible by 7, 12 is also not divisible by 7. So here 7 we cannot do anything. But look for the remaining two. Remaining two, are they divisible by the same number, 9 and 12? Yes. So the condition is satisfied. Minimum 2 should be divisible by the same number. So here 9 and 12 are divisible by the same number. Which same number? 3. So you are going to divide this with 3. Now we know that 7 is not divisible by 3. So what you do is you write that 7 as it is here. Write 7 as it is, because we are not doing any division for 7. You are only dividing these two with 3. So next one, 9 divided by 3, it is 3. And next 12, 3 in 12 how many times? 3 fours are 12. Now again you will see, 3 numbers are 7, 3 and 4. You are going to divide. So when you divide, the condition is minimum 2 should be divisible. Here among the 3, any 2 of them are divisible by the same number? 7 and 3 if you take, is it possible? 3 and 4? 4 and 7? None of the cases it is possible. So this step is the last step where further it is not possible for us to divide minimum 2 numbers. So one number we can divide, 4 it's possible. But what is our condition? Minimum 2 numbers should be divisible. So we stop this division here. And LCM will be product of all these outer numbers. So 5 into 3 into 7 into 3 into 4 will be the LCM of 35, 45 and 60. Now look at this. It is different from what we have learned earlier. There it is only prime numbers. But here see, 4 is a composite number. So it doesn't matter whether it is a prime number or a composite number. Only thing is you have to keep in mind, minimum 2 numbers should be divisible by the same number what we are thinking to divide with. So multiply all this, 5 into 3, 15, 15 into 4, 60, 60 into 3, 180, 180 into 7. So how much this will be equal to 1260. That is the LCM of 35, 45 and 60. So clear? One more example we will do. Suppose you are asked to find the LCM of 16, 20 and 45. How to do it? So you are going to do the division. What is our condition? Minimum 2. So first let us see whether all the 3 are divisible by the same number. This is an even number. This is also an even number. So both of these will be divisible by 2. But this is an odd number. It won't be divisible by 2. So if you are taking 3, this is not divisible by 3. This is also not divisible by 3. But this is divisible by 3. If you take 4, this is divisible by 4. This is divisible by 4. But this is not divisible by 4. So the condition we can apply now. Minimum 2. Minimum 2 should be divisible by the same number. So you can choose any number. Only thing is, 2 of them should be divisible by the number what we are choosing. So what number shall we take? Any number you can take. If you want, you can take 2, 3 or 3 anyway, it is not possible. Why? Because only one of the numbers is divisible. So take cases where 2 numbers are divisible. Shall I take 2 and then do? Okay. So with 2, I am going to divide. 2 of the numbers are divisible by 2, which are 16 and 20. So 16, how many times? 2 8s are 16. 20, how many times? 2 into 10 is 20. But 45 is not divisible by 2. So what you should do? Write down that 45 as it is. That 45 will be written as it is. Now next, you are going to take in such a way that 2 of the numbers is divisible by the same number. Which number you want to take? Shall we take this 8 and 10 are divisible by 2. 10 and 45 are divisible by 5. So whichever one you can take. Shall we take with 2? Okay, then 2. 2 in 8, 2 4s are 8. 2 in 10, 2 5s are 10. Again, 45 is not divisible by 2. So bring that 45 down as it is. Now, this case, 2 numbers divisible by the same number. Which 2 numbers? 5 and 45 are divisible by 5. So you are going to divide with 5. 4 is not divisible by 5. So what you will do? Write that 4 as it is. 5 divided by 5, 1. 45 divided by 5 is 9. Now further, are we going to do? No. Why? Because none of these numbers are divisible by the same number. So our LCM will be, what is LCM? Product of all the outer numbers. So 2 into 2 into 5 into 4 into 9 into 1. This 1, whether you multiply with 1 or not, the result is the same, because any number multiplied by 1 is a number itself. So it's not necessary to put that 1 over there. If you insist that you suppose if you go wrong, if you feel, then put that 1 also. So now what is the product? Find it out. 2 2s are 4. 4 into 5, 20. 20 into 4 is 80. 80 into 9 is 720. So the LCM of 16, 20 and 45 is 720. So hope you have understood how to find the LCM by division method. This is division method. So three methods we have learned to find HCF and LCM. First method is by finding the common factor and common multiple. The second method is by prime factorization. And third method is by long division method for finding LCM of more than 2 numbers. More than 3 or 4 numbers, if it is there to find LCM, you can use the division method. And hope you have understood the steps for different methods. And as far as possible, you go for LCM, you go for this division method, and HCF, you can go for prime factorization, or LCM also you can go for prime factorization, doesn't matter, whichever is easy for you, go for that. It will not be stated that you should go by this method alone. So common factor and common multiple method, it's just for information purpose only. We are not going to go in detail to do with that way. Main thing is, in higher classes you will either go by division method or by the prime factorization method. So hope you have understood all the concepts what you have dealt today. Thank you.